some Splatoon today. So this is a new map, Camp Sugarfish. I really like this range. It's not because it's new. I don't know why, but whenever there's DLC, it just always seems to get overhyped. It just never fails. And then eventually it just gets worn out. Like the Mario Kart DLC, that was fun when it first came out. But then like everyone online, like every round is always playing as in the DLC courses. And it just got real stale. And even now, almost like November, December, like almost 8 months after the DLC's out, it's still like going. Like, everyone's just only playing DLC courses. And then it's like a DLC in the middle. But that's beside the point. Anyways, this is Camp Sugarfish. It's in the map, it's really big. And it's like a giant maze. Pretty much. Kind of. It depends on how you imagine. I just imagine it's a giant freaking maze. Because if you look at the map, which is on the map here, I'll show you. It just looks real confusing. There's like a lot of hiding spots that you can go on. I think some of the other teams just like walked up here. They didn't even see me. So it's just a lot of room that you can make turf. That you can just spot anyway. My first time playing on this map, I think I got like 1,400 points. And my team didn't win. Like, all of that was just from me just covering the turf. So I was by myself the whole game. Like, I didn't get any kills until I got like 3 in like the last minute. So if you separate yourself from the team, you can get a lot of points in this. Like, it's really common if you want to pick it yourself. Or anything, because it's like a giant maze. And the ink streak here. Let's place it right there. So the weapon I'm using is the Aerospray RG. Pretty sure it's Aerospray RG. I always miss the chance. Almost positive this is the RG. This one is the gold one with like the ink strike and the ink mines or whatever. It's that one. So looks like we won. Looks like we got a Cloud9 logo on the right side there by the spawn. And yeah, I wasn't the team really. That was okay, another Aerospray was. Aerospray buds. I'm gonna join a different one just to keep it fresh. Wishing for a battle to join. No. There we go. All right. It's like 10:30 p.m. on the... I want to say in the bottom of my balls, the 24th of July. And I'm gonna say that I'm most likely to be wrong. Anyways, we're on Camp Sugarfish again. I'm on the purple team. And this person's not letting me get into my zone. I want to play with the people, too. This map is just so big. I'm quite forgot a little bit. because I think it's go the other way. Make it real somewhat safe so I can use this. So whenever you have an end strike with like any weapon, you want to make sure you're somewhat safe before you use it. Because that can deliver a punch. If you're like right by an enemy who will use it, you can get messed up pretty bad. If you can't decide where you want to fire it right away. Which I'm pretty good with determining where I want to put an in strike, like on the first glance of the map. Like almost every match is like an area. It's like wide open areas that you can just like shoot it and get a lot of points. Like every map has that with the exclusion of Fortnite. Like that map you just can't place an aim strike anywhere and be like safe. Or knowing that you're gonna get like all the turf that you just shot. So it's just something like condensed walls there. So like I was saying earlier, like at the beginning of the video, like DLC to me, DLC almost always is overhyped. Like you cannot have DLC and then not like go online or whatever in the DLC and not like see it just everywhere. And like when like the DLC characters came out, like for Mewtwo it was especially bad because there was like the wave of the people who bought both games. I thought I was on top of the wall, so I was turning around to shoot that guy. But then like, I started falling and I can't turn around. Anywho. But, like when Mewtwo came out for Smash Brothers, like there was the way of the people like me who bought both the games and registered it and then got like an email from Code Nintendo with the code to download it. So there's that way. And then there was the big one. Like people bought him and he was just like everywhere. Honestly, I would have been fine if I didn't have Mewtwo. I didn't need Mewtwo to live. There's a lot of DLC I don't need. But it's just cool to have, you know. And then when the Lucas, Ryu, and Roy DLC came out, like, you just saw, like, mostly, especially Ryu, you just saw him everywhere. Like, you almost always put on Dreamland and Suzaku Castle when you're playing with friends. And then Mario Kart, don't even get me started on Mario Kart, oh my god. You cannot. Like, the last time I played Mario Kart Online had been, like, after the second DLC came out. You cannot play an online game of Mario Kart without seeing any DLC anywhere anymore. Like, it's just everywhere. And if you haven't realized, I can't trigger fish. Get rid of these stones. Alright. Mario Kart, like you just, like, there's always, you can never go through a rotation without a DLC map, you know, like the thing, and then, like, everyone picks it, because they can. And sometimes I wonder if people, like, that don't have, well, I actually wonder if people that don't have the DLC, can they, like, race in that? Because I know, for Mario Kart, you have the option to race. If you want to race with the DLC or not, maybe the DLC courses are thin lines or so. I know you have that option. But, like, people who don't have the DLC, can they race online in the DLC courses? You'd think you'd be able to. You'd think you wouldn't be able to. Not a secret, that is an ink mod. That's what that is for. Your ink show. It's gonna blow up sometime. Yep. Yep. This one right here should be a troll. The second wave of DLC came out. Like, it was Ribbon Road especially. Ribbon Road. Like, you just always played on Ribbon Road. If you didn't play on Ribbon Road, you were satanic or something. I don't know. And then there's, like, Beanie Bowl costumes that came out. And, like, you just saw just, like, so many enemies with, like, Mario hats and, like, Link hats. Like, I've only seen, like, one Captain Falcon racing. Oh, I got two of them. I've only seen one Captain Falcon. Beanie Bowl racing line. One time I'll do another. Turf War. I'm at 4 kills and 1 death. Getting up in the ranks. Just if I do good in the Turf War, which I usually do, I'll have this gear maxed out on camera. Pretty cool. Because this gear that I'm like, getting XP for right now, it's pretty bad. Because I think my bike helmet has like two of like the same thing. It's just my gear isn't good. The ones that I have right now. But I got some good stuff. What I want to do, I just want to be like so pimped. And it's like collect like all the super sea snail things. Just collect all those. Just collect a lot of them. And then just get all the gear, and then just make it all so it has like 4 item slot things. And that's just what I want to do. I think that'd be really cool. So you just have like everything that's just always 4 slots. And I saw you. Oh, I didn't see you. I was under something. I'm slow. No, stop it. I don't like you. I'm sorry whoever's drawing that was, but I need to disrespect it. I need disrespect in my life. It's probably the truest thing I've ever said. I do need disrespect. Find an insert right there. Certain some points. I don't know, 400 or something. I'm gonna get a minute left. Get back here. Die. Thank you. No! It's a killer whale. Those killer whales, they just anally rape you. You just can't live on. So now it appears the Kraken. That thing is stupid. Looks like I'm barely gonna get this in the time when it finishes. I'm gonna die right here. No, I'm living. I need to get one more kill somehow. Here it is, he's not in my cup. Got him! Come on, taunts.